All right, so the last topic I'd like to cover in PomDP land is a line of work that I am somewhat fond of that is called predictive state representation. So let me say a little bit about the motivation behind studying this, and we'll talk a little bit about the representation itself, but we're not going to talk much about algorithms that actually make use of this. There is a literature if you want to dive in. All right, so here's the basic premise of this line of work. So we talked about PomDP. So PomDPs, when we're moving around in a PomDP, we're tracking the belief state, which is a distribution over states, right?
Right.
So here's the thing. The states are not observable, right?
Right.
So how can we ever hope to learn in a PomDP when we never actually get to see these underlying states? They're never observed. So you could ask yourself, do they even exist? Or are they just kind of useful fictions of our imagination? There's nothing that we can ever do to test, hey, was this the state we were actually in? The answer is, I don't know. I mean, if we're learning in a PomDP, we're just creating this notion of states to provide some structure to the observations that we've seen.
Is this like a tree in the forest thing?
Yeah. If a PomDP is solved in a forest, does anybody know whether or not they exist? And the answer is, nee.
No, I think you're right. I mean, we're making this stuff up anyway, right?
Yeah, and in the case that somebody gives us a PomDP and says, would you please plan in this? It's a reasonable representation to work with. But if you're in a reinforcement learning setting, you never get to see these underlying states. You can never actually collect statistics about them. In fact, most of the good work that I've seen that uses PomDPs, they don't learn the PomDP. They actually send, you know, I'm going to say grad students, out into the field to measure underlying states and then measure the observation function. They actually kind of instrument the world to build the PomDP, and then they can act in the PomDP successfully later. But it's just, there's really no good way to learn about the states.
Or even that they're real.
Even that they're real.
Okay, so now that you've blown my mind, what does this have to do with predictive state representation?
All right, so the idea of a predictive state representation, or a PSR, is that the thing that we're going to use for representation isn't going to be probability distributions over these possibly fictional states, but instead they're going to be probabilities of the outcomes of future predictions. So like, I'm in a state where it's about an 80% chance it's going to rain tomorrow.
Okay, which doesn't require an actual state.
Well, and that was maybe not a great example. So let me give a more concrete example to kind of ground this idea out.